Hi, this is Mary Poplin with Boris FX, and today I'm going to show you how to do a really quick tattoo remove right on your talent in Premiere. Removing objects like tattoos or logos is a pretty common task in post, but most Adobe users think this can only be done in After Effects. Here, I will show you how complex object removal can be done directly in Premiere with the Mocha Pro plugin and a little help from Photoshop. So let's get started. We're going to go to our effects panel and type in Mocha. Drag and drop Mocha Pro right onto our clip. Once Mocha's on our clip, we can go to Effects Controls and launch Mocha directly from our timeline. Please note that if you open Mocha and it looks like this, you need to switch to the classic workflow. The Essentials workspace does not contain the remove module, so you need to work in classic mode. Since this reads directly from our timeline, we can work directly on our footage. I'm going to zoom in and draw a shape around this whole arm, just like this, and grab all of the tracking data for this tattoo area and her arm. It helps if you go a little bit outside the edges, because then Mocha can find the texture more easily. Let's go ahead and track perspective, turn our surface tool on, and I want you to remember that the shape is where the track is looking, and the surface tool is what the track is doing. Because we're tracking translation, scale, rotation, shear, and perspective, we'll get all of the data for how this moves, even in Z space. If I hit track backwards, Mocha will follow the texture of her arm through the scene. This is how we end up with accurate data. Now, there's a couple of different ways you could try to solve this shot without using the remove. You could try using a replace by creating a negative shape with a roto mask and then moving the background plate around behind the object. We actually don't want to do that. What we're going to do instead is we're going to use the very powerful remove tool to replace this tattoo with just a sort of image of the skin itself. To do that, we need an accurate track of what the arm is doing. The remove works with two different shapes. You need a background track and a foreground shape to define the object you want to remove. The background track must be tracked, but the remove shape can be something you hand animated or something that you link to the background track, which is what I'm going to show you here. Now that our track is complete, I'm going to call this background. I'm going to turn the gear off because we're no longer tracking it, and I'm going to hide it. With my X-spline tool, I'm going to make a new shape right around the area that I want to track. I do want to show you something though, and that is the foreground shape that I'm using for my remove, and let's call this remove, is going to have to be inside of your background shape. If it's not inside your background shape, you will not get a successful remove. So background has to be bigger than your remove shape. Now, what's important to note here is that I don't have a track for this foreground shape. So I'm going to go to link to track, and I'm going to link this to our background. Now our shape is going to follow our tattoos over time, and that's good. So now what I need to do is I need to find an area where the tattoo is largest in frame, least blurry, and closest to camera, and that's going to be my clean plate. So I'm going to go over to my remove tool, and I'm going to hit create clean plate. We're going to save our clean plate, and then inside of Photoshop, open our clean plate, zoom in, take our lasso tool, draw a shape around our tattoos we want to remove. Go to Edit, Fill, Content Aware Fill, and save our plate. Back inside of Mocha, we're going to use clean plates exclusively, and you'll see that our clean plate is being taken from frame 258. This is important because frame 258 has to be the frame that we use for our remove, or it will be offset by whatever the difference in our frame numbers is when we do our remove. So what we're going to do is we're going to use clean plates exclusively with linear illumination modeling. Illumination modeling is important because it can match the remove to the lighting of the shot. So none would be no illumination modeling. Linear is where it tries to raise and lower the value of the entire shape. And interpolate is where it tries to gradiate lighting changes over the shape. We're going to choose linear. Interpolate can cause artifacts that are really helpful for things like caustics, but not so good for bare pieces of skin. We're going to turn our overlays off and hit render. And we should get a beautiful remove throughout our shot. I don't have to render everything inside of Mocha. I can simply save and close. And now right inside of Premiere, I can go to Module Renders, Remove, and check our render box. And we'll render our remove right back to our timeline. So now I can apply my matte for the remove. With the mask on and a little bit of edge feathering, I can hide any sort of edges or other problems that my remove might encounter. It just helps everything blend better back into the arm. You could also use blurs and grain matching to hide any other errors that you might see. And now all we have to do is render right back to our timeline, and our remove is done. And just like that, you can create a very simple remove right on your timeline inside of Premiere. And of course, you could use Mocha to replace this tattoo. With that in mind, enjoy this quick preview of using Power Mesh as an insert, which is going to be part two of this tutorial, coming soon. If you have any questions, you can find us on www.borisfx.com, where you can find more information on our forums, on free training, and our tutorials.